So here we are at Wind Rock, Tennessee. Just got the took the doors off the Samurai and put the half doors on. Just got done putting a roof on it. So it's got a tin roof on it now, and I put a flipped up windshield on it. So a couple of the modifications I've done since the last time I went wheeling. So I got a flip up, I put a light up in front. I did put some Samurai back covers on it to keep it a little drier. So just some of the improvements I did to it. But we set up camp here. Here at Wind Rock Park, Tennessee. So these are the other rigs that we're actually wheeling with. This is our mid camp. This is a camp for everybody. We got one camp to camp everybody. And I'm gonna walk over there and show you guys the other rig. So this is Mike's rig. He's got a really capable Jeep. He's gonna be wheeling with us today. And then we got Charles' Jeep. He's actually wheeling with us today too. And then we got Larry's Razor. So this is John's rig. He's gonna be wheeling with us today too. And then that's my little side-by-side I bring. And like I said, that's our base camp we got set up.
Okay, we're just now starting trail 15. You can see that it's been raining and the trail is awful wet. It's giving us some hard times in some spots. This is John going up the very beginning of it. My brother Dean is recording.
Which way are you gonna go?
Thank you.
lowest side to go up yet.
They don't know they want to go that way or that way.
They don't know which side they want to go up.
That way or that way.
So we stop right here. The trail actually got a fork in it. So we're trying to figure out which way to go. We always like taking a harder line. And it does look like the going to the left is the most difficult line.
Give it a bump. Nope. Move over that way some. There you go. You gotta get a little bump. Nope. Right there. Now go give it a bump. Keep it going.
Okay, right here, John in a copper Jeep done made it through this little section. The green Sammy, Dale, he made it through this section. The Razor had a little bit of a hard time. And here me, I'm Dale, I'm actually backing up right now to help the side-by-side have a winching point to winch up. What made this spot difficult was there's a little ledge, like a little rock sticking out of the mountain, and it was hard to get around it.
Yeah, hold it for me, hold it. Check your back cooler, Charles. It's about ready to fall out.
So this is that little rock we were talking about that's hanging out on the trail. You had to get a little speed to get over it. And also, like I said, it's been raining and it's really muddy. And that's why actually down there below, this is the trail to the left. If you went to the right, it would have been much easier. But like again, we do like taking the most toughest lines. And this is Charles directing Mike on getting around it.
Go! Go!
Turn back up. Alright, now stop. We're going to do it one more time and then we'll pull cable.
Alright.
I want you to ask the driver a little bit this time. Driver a little bit and give her hell. I mean a full lap of all.
Keep it going, keep it going, keep it going. Yeah,
don't get that tire there over on the other side of that rock. You're not going to be. There
you go, like that. So, right here, we're having just a little bit of problems. The Jeep kept them wanting to slide into that big rock. So what we found out, if we would keep that left rear tire above or below that lower rock, we'd be able to get better positioning and be able to make it up.
Can you front dig it around? Y'all look good at me though, you're wrong. Can you do a front dig around? Can you front dig it around?
So now that we got him up on that rock high, the whole reason why is his rocker on the left-hand side was hanging up on that big rock, and it would hold his tires up in the air where he couldn't get over it. So now that we got him up that high, now we were able to just kind of move his front end around and get him over it.
You're off the ground about 4 inches. Oh, you got it, you got it.
Well,
you did, rear dip. Got your rear dip. There you go, there you go.
Right here you can see my left frame rail is hung up on that rock, so I'm kind of turtling right now. So I decided to go ahead and just back off of it and try the second line, the line that John got up on. Here in a few minutes you'll see me back off of it and try the other line. see I'm up high enough now that my frame rail ain't touching, but now I'm in a serious tilt right now. So you'll see me eventually kick it out of rear and just have front end only, and I do a slight dig to get my front end back down where it's more level, more comfortable. Like I said earlier, you can tell it's really muddy and wet. You can see the water sitting on ledges. You can see the mud on my tires. If it was a little drier, I probably would walk up these ledges a little bit.
Straighten it up, yeah.
So we're getting at the end of trail 15. So the end of 15, you stay to the right-hand side, it's a tougher line. If you go to the left side of the trail, it's a little bit easier. All we got here is just real steep ledges, one after another. And it's, like I said, it's just make it a little difficult being wet, but we work our way through it.
Back tires up. between those two V notches be good.
That tire's up.
That's the end of Trail 15. We're heading back to camp. So please like and subscribe my videos. You can also find me on YouTube under Rock Crawling Green Sammy if you want to see some more videos. Thanks for watching. You can tell the world you never was my girl. You can burn my clothes when I'm gone. Oh, you can tell your friends just what a fool I've been and laugh and joke about me on the phone. You can tell my arms go back into the phone. You can tell my feet to hit the floor. Oh, you can tell my lips to tell my fingertips they won't be reaching out for you no more. Don't tell my heart, my aching, breaking heart, I just don't think he'd understand. And if you tell my heart, my aching, breaking heart, he might blow up and kill this man. For my mind, it might be walking out on me today. But don't tell my heart, my achy, breaky heart, I just don't think he'd understand. And if you tell my heart, my achy, breaky heart,